just did on our feet, worship the Lord this afternoon. He is worthy to be praised, and I think somebody shout hallelujah. Is he worthy in this house? Has he been there for you in the middle of the valley? Has he been there for you in the middle of the bed? Did he bring you out? Did he give you help? Are you saved? Are you sanctified? You got the Holy Ghost.
Jesus' name. Thank you. baptized over there, that you are going to make the decision to be baptized. And you're going to make the decision to accept the Lord as your personal Savior. But the minute that you do that, the devil is going to be on your case, and the devil is all against that. He's going to do everything he possibly can do to distract you and try to get you not to live for the Lord, but to listen to him and go the wrong way. Now, what you have to do to that old snake that's coming up out there is you got to stop sickness. bend his knee.
What are you
doing? Let's remember his name as we go to our Lord in prayer. Kate Phillips, Michelle Stowe, Diane Brundage, Skip Gordon, Rebecca Caldwell, Mark Tucker, Tammy Cruz, Stephanie Crew, Laura Grinder, Jackson Brothers, Kevin LaFlam, Linda George, James Shelton, Wade Grizzle, Rebecca Baskins, Claire Bingham, and Chris Jarber, all back to the pray for them. Joy Baskins has been dealing with several medical issues lately. Jason Barnett is preparing for a liver transplant. Pray for surgery and recovery. Tom Seacross is needing a lung transplant. Remington Boswell has lacerated liver and bruised kidney. Pray as he recovers. Rick Gibbon and Richard Hanson, both in healing and advice. I can ask motions if you guys are going down tonight. Let's all stand and go to our Lord in prayer tonight. Heavenly Father, Lord, we just thank you for your presence, Lord. We just thank you for being here in the house at MPCC, Lord. We know that the minute the doors are open tonight, Lord, that you enter. Lord, we can feel your presence here tonight, Lord. We know that there's somebody right here under my brother Rodney Williams' voice tonight, Lord, and is here for a message. Lord, they need to apply that here in their life, Lord. And we know that the message you laid on this heart, Lord, that they can go outside these doors and apply to our everyday life. And Lord, I just ask you right now to continue to be with the remainder of this service, Lord, that you be with this praise team. Lord, we just thank you for what they do for us. And Lord, we just thank you for everything that you represent here at MPCC, Lord. And Lord, we just ask you to take this offer tonight, Lord. We ask you that you break the blessing of your kingdom. And everybody in the house, be careful. Give you all the honor, the glory, and praise. And everybody said, amen. Amen.
Yes, you are. Let's see. Let's see. Thank you. Flashlights back off. Today, when we leave, I want the lights on.
16. We're going to go to 16 and 33. Brother called me and asked me what kind of Bible I was going to preach out of tonight. This is my granddaddy William's Bible. Amen. I thought it'd be appropriate because I felt like what Pastor told me that so many years ago that this is coming full circle. And I want to bring a little bit of my grandfather with me. Amen. If you can, please stand for the reading of God's word. And it came to pass, as we went to pray, a certain damsel, possessed with the spirit of divination, met us, and which brought her masters much gain by soothsaying. Boy, now that's a word. Amen. Soothsaying.
Boy, okay, brother.
We got some soothsaying out of right there. Hey, some of y'all soothsaying right now. Amen.
No.
Amen. And the same followed Paul and us and cried, saying, these men are the servants of the Most High God, which show unto us the way of salvation. And this did she many days. But Paul, being grieved, turned and said to the Spirit, I command thee in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her. And he came out in the same hour. I like it that he came out right then. Amen. I like it that he didn't wait 4 or 5 days or 6 weeks. He come on out right then in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. And when her master saw that their hope of their gains were gone, what was right? They caught Paul and Silas and drew them into the marketplace and to the rulers, brought them to the magistrates, saying, these men, being the Jews, do exceedingly trouble our city, and teach customs which are not lawful for us to receive, neither to observe, being Romans. And the multitudes rose up together against them, and the magistrates rent off their clothes and commanded to beat them. And when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safe. Whose having received such a charge, thrust them into the inner prison and made their feet fast in the stocks. And at the midnight hour, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God.
Come on.
And the prisoners heard them. And suddenly, y'all hear me right there, I said, and suddenly, amen, and suddenly, amen, just the same as when Jesus was dying on the cross, and suddenly, amen, there was a great earthquake, amen, so that the foundations of the prisons were shaken, and immediately all the doors were open, and everyone's bands were loosed. And the keeper of the prison had wakened from his sleep, seeing that the prison doors were open, he drew no harm, for we are all here. Then he called for a light, and it sprang in and came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas. He brought them out, said, sirs, what must I do to be saved?
Amen.
And they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. If there's somebody here tonight, Lord, that don't know you as a personal Savior,
sure. Lord, let them get that thing right tonight, Lord, before we leave. We love you. We praise you. We lift you up in Jesus' name. And all God's children says,
amen.
Amen, amen. And you may be seated. Amen. See, in the story, there was a woman with a bad spirit. There was a woman with a bad spirit. Amen. You see, there's all kinds of spirits in this world, and there's some that ain't good. Amen. And they were using it for gain. They were using her to gain wealth and money. But when Paul saw this evil spirit, he just cast it out in the name of Jesus. And they thought that was worthy enough to throw them in prison. Amen? Amen. I'm going to come back to the scripture in a minute. We're going to talk about a few points here, and then we'll get back to Paul and Silas. Amen? If y'all would, just allow me to speak for a little bit, and then we'll get back to Paul and Silas and what is really going on here. You see, I believe that there's a definition of radical praise that people don't understand. I think sometimes, I want y'all to take a look right here. Y'all get it on camera. This is my new Apple. Amen. Amen. Sometimes people think that speaking in tongues, brother, I might come down here with you. I just can't help it. Sometimes people think speaking in tongues, but if you talk to some folks, they say, yeah, that's them people, that's that radical praise people, amen. Them people, they just radical, 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 amen. Amen. I know I ain't by myself in here, amen. And I don't have to tell Mount Pleasant about speaking in tongues, amen. Y'all heard all the things, amen. Y'all heard all the things, amen. I know I don't have to tell you. But can I tell you this? Speaking in tongues is a gift from the Spirit.
Yes.
That's right.
And it's not radical praise.
Right.
At all. Amen. Right. Not even a little bit. Amen. Not even some. Amen.
Right.
Something that dancing. My brother, y'all see my brother dancing up here?
All right.
I don't care if your legs are bad. I don't care if you got a bad back. I don't speaking in tongues. How about dancing and running around the room, casting out demons? Or how about this? This is a good one, because this happened to me right down here. Being slain in the spirit.
Come on, man.
Amen. Just be slain in the spirit.
Fall out, man.
I'm going to tell y'all a story. First time I ever got slain in the spirit. Pretty funny. I think it's pretty funny now, amen. It wasn't funny to me then.
Come on.
We went to a Christian conference. We ain't been long, got saved. He's going to a little church in Winterfield. Had a Christian conference. 3 nights of school, 3 nights of teaching. Come one night, he said, tonight we're going to be baptized in the Spirit. This week, stood in the back of the room, and there's a bunch of people, a bunch of couples with. And I started watching them, and he was praying, he would raise a hand, and he'd pray with them, and the next thing you know, they'd fall down and fall. Sometimes they'd be shaking, sometimes they'd be speaking in tongues, sometimes they'd just be popping around, amen? I got closer to that door. My wife was right here. Got all my hand was on that door. I mean, I got in there, I said, this kid's a little closer, I'm going to have to get up out of here. And then, Pastor Curtis, he said, Robbie, come up here.
Oh, boy.
I said, good. I'm good. See you in class in the morning. He said, come on. So I eased up, amen. And I told him. And I told him, plain as day. I said, brother, you're not going to make me fall down that floor. And I'm not going to be speaking in no kind of tongue. He said, I can't make you do anything, son.
That's right.
But I want you to trust me for just a second, because I'm going to pray for you. And all I want you to do is start talking. And just start talking. I'm going to just pray for you. Well, I guess go ahead and make a long story short. I got about the floor about 20 minutes later.
Hot.
I'm talking about sweating. I didn't have a dry thread on me. Amen. And I tell you tonight, the gifts of the Spirit is the gifts of the Spirit.
You said it.
If you have the gifts of the Spirit,
right,
you need to use and practice them every single day.
Right.
When you have the gifts of the Spirit, you're going to feel completely different than that person that don't.
You're right.
But can I tell you that speaking in tongues, dancing and running around the room, casting out demons, being slain in the spirit, none of these is right for praise.
That's
none of these are right. Paul and Silas, they had right for praise.
Come on.
Paul and Silas, they had radical praise. Because Paul and Silas was beaten. They had stripes. They took off their clothes. They were spit on. They were cursed at. They were took into prison. They were put in the midst of the prison with all the worst people there. They were tied down, hands and feet. They were bleeding. They were hurt. But still, after all that and everything that they were going through, the deepest storm of their life, they started praying and singing praise unto God. Amen. If we can get across to our table that we're wearing the deepest storms of our life, just stop for a minute and get out of the pity party for just one second. We're going to get God to show up. We can show up. on the church window for a long time. Amen? Been saying it for years. But sometimes when we get in a deep and dark place, we don't really believe it.
Yeah. Oh, that's when you got
it. We get stuck in our own little dark place. We get put back in the closet. But all he wants to do is you talk to him and give it to him. And he's going to immediately, within the hour, amen, immediately, within the hour, get you through this storm. Radical praise is what's missing in most of our lives. Radical praise is being missed by pastors. It's being missed by music directors. It's been missed by keyboard players, drummers. It's been missed by everyone. Why do we miss the radical praise that God gives us every single day? God tells us in His Word to pick up our cross and walk with it every day.
That's right.
Not walk with it every day till we got a problem. Amen? But ain't that what we do? Ain't that what we do? It takes us a little while, don't we, Brother Jerry? It takes us a little while sometimes. You know why? Why poor, 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 man, oh Lord, help me. I need to look, I got another job. Amen. I got it. Life goes on. But sometimes we need to rise up praise in our life.
Mm-hmm.
In your deepest, in the darkest moments of your
life. You said it.
Because when you praise God in your storm, in your deepest storm, that's when you're going to see the miracle of God.
Amen to that.
That's when he's going to, that's when, and you remember when all the disciples got in the bottom of the ship and the waves were coming over the side of the ship and Jesus went down in the bottom and laid his head out of the pillow and had a bunch of chicken. Amen. Y'all remember? Amen. He didn't have a chicken. Amen. Amen. He just laid down on the pillow and went to sleep. And then they came down and they said, Lord, don't you even care if we perish? You know what he said to them? Don't you know who is with you?
That's right. That's right.
For every soul that sits in this place today and has asked Jesus Christ to move into your heart, don't you know who is with you?
That's right.
In your deepest and your darkest storm.
He's in you.
Don't you know who's holding your hand? Don't you know who's catching all the tears? Don't you know why that you're still alive today? Don't you know why you made it out of the hospital? Don't you know who pulled you through away here? Don't you know but just up the road, it was a bad wreck. Mm-hmm. And I could have very easily been in that wreck.
That's right.
You know, the Spirit might have sent that there. Amen. God's always there.
Yes.
He said He'll never leave you, He'll never forsake you.
Amen to that. Amen.
Let me tell you about a few more people in the Bible that has some radical praise. Amen. Y'all okay? I don't know anything. Shadrach.
Meshach
and Abednego.
That's right.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego now. Now these guys have some radical praise. Amen. They have some radical praise. The king said, you're going to bow down to the golden image. And they said, no, sir. No, sir, we're not going to bow down to your golden image. He said, well, if you don't bow down to this golden image, we're just going to pick you up and throw you in the fire furnace. He said, go ahead. Go ahead. Throw me in the fire furnace. Because my God can deliver me.
Amen to that.
That's right.
I like, you know what I like better, even better than that, than my God can deliver me? I like the fact that even if He don't.
That's right.
Even if He don't. believing that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego is God. Amen. That lady at the well. Y'all remember the lady at the well? I remember the lady at the well. Amen. That lady at the well. Man, she wasn't no good. Amen. She wasn't a good woman. Amen. Even Jesus told her that. Amen. Jesus told her, he said, honey, you've been married 5 times. Can't y'all see Jesus saying that? Honey, you've been married 5 times, and the one you with now ain't your husband. He said, but if you take a drink of this water, amen. If you take a drink of the water that I got, amen, you'll never thirst again. Right there is why I changed my whole mind about women preachers. Right there, brother. Changed my whole mind about women preachers. I expect, well, women preachers, I don't know about that, women preachers. But you know when you read that about that lady in the well? After she got saved, she went out there and she told about Jesus, and she preached about Jesus in that whole town, and it said they all got saved. Amen. Boat when it wasn't really good to be. Amen. And the rain did not come just from the heaven. The Bible says that the rain came from the heavens. It came from the north, the south, the east, the west. It even come up. The rocks cried out with rain. And the mountains cried out with rain. And you see, it took 40 days to cover the whole world. Him and his family on that boat. That was radical praise. What is God telling you to do right now that you've been putting off? Putting off. And your blessings right around the corner. Your blessings is right there. Noah had radical praise in a time where there's no way anybody could believe. How about blind Bartimaeus? Blind Bartimaeus was sitting on the side of the road when he called on one time. Y'all done seen it, amen? I'll see you at Walmart the other day, amen? Give $1 and a little Bible, amen? How many of y'all give $1 and a little Bible, amen? Most of the time we give $2 and a little Bible. I keep a little, keep some of these in the church, amen? Just for that reason. You never know what you're going to do. You're going to touch the Bible, say the word of God will never come back over it, amen?
That's right.
So if you give it, somebody's going to get a blessing from that, amen? My Bartimaeus was sitting on the side of the road and he was shaking his little cup and they said Jesus was coming. Jesus of Nazareth, he's coming. And that same crowd is coming through with him. But when he come through, he had all the religious folks with him. Amen. So Blind Bartimaeus, he said, Jesus!
Down.
Hey, Jesus! Son of David! Help me! You know what them Christian folk did? Religious leaders. Hey, be quiet, sit down. Jesus is coming. Very important. Very important. You know what blind Bartimaeus did? Hey, Jesus! He ran in the door. And when Jesus heard, he said, bring him to me. He didn't go to him.
Right.
He told the ones that told him to shut up and go get him and bring him to me. Somebody that's a hand clap of praise. He told him to go get him and bring him to him. And when he stood before Jesus, he said, son, what can I do for you today? He said, son, I might have my sight. He said, your faith is made you whole.
That's right.
Your faith is made you whole. Give his sight right then. But he could have been quiet. And he could have went and hid. And he'd still be out there right now with his little cardboard sign and his little jingle cup. Amen? But he trusted it. He trusted what he believed that Jesus could do. I need you tonight to trust in what Jesus can really do. If Jesus was standing before you right now, right here tonight, and he asked you, said, what could I do for you? What would your answer be? If he's standing right in front of you tonight, if he's asking you, what can I do for you? What would you want? I probably wouldn't even be standing. I'd probably be already down on the knee, probably laying down, prostrate on the floor. Amen. Praising God. Amen. You see, he had radical praise. Radical praise is when you believe Jesus so much over the problem. Amen? It's when you believe that Jesus can do things that the problem, it don't matter about the problem because you got Jesus. Amen?
I hear that.
And Jesus can overcome these things, but if we don't, then we're just going to be with him and it's still going to be great and glory. Amen? This is what we got to take a hold of.
Yeah.
I told this to my wife. I preached this message a few weeks ago. Told this to my wife. In your cancer, have radical praise.
Yes, amen. That's right. Yes.
Come on. Well, you say, listen, you used to have cancer. Amen. In your brokenness. In your brokenness.
Yes.
Hey, when things in your down and out, and you don't think nobody's there, in your deepest and your darkest and your broken moments of your life, there's Jesus. Amen. There's Jesus.
Thank you.
talking about now, not going to buy a hand, into addictions. Into addiction, there's radical praise you can overcome. Into a depression. Depression has no place in the Christian body.
I hear that.
Come on, say amen.
Amen.
I I think what we need in our lives and our in our in our churches is radical praise. Amen.
Amen.
Right. I ain't putting down nobody that does the spirits of the spirit. Amen. If God gives you the gift to do whatever you better be doing it. Amen. You want to see the blessings from God? Do what God tells you to do. Amen.
I hear that.
I want to write down in this place, though. It will be somebody say, you know what? I can do a better job. I can do a better job in my life. In worshiping God in my dark moments. I can do a better job in my life praising God when all I'm thinking about is me. It's tough. Amen. I comes into play a lot of times. I wonder if there's somebody here tonight that don't know Jesus as their Savior. They hear all this about radical praise, speaking in tongues, being slain in the spirit, and they're not really sure about none of it. Can I be clear what the Bible says on salvation? The only way to heaven is through Jesus. It's the only way to heaven. You must receive and ask Jesus into your heart. Then you must pick up your cross and walk with him every day. And we're not perfect. We can't be perfect. That's why we have repentance every single day. We need to repent because we got old flesh mind. We get mad. Somebody crosses us in the road. Amen. Things happen. Got to repent. Because this unrepented sin cannot enter the gates of heaven.
That's right.
Understand that. If you ain't never heard nothing like ever that I said tonight, unrepented sin will not enter the gates of heaven. Amen. We must repent. We must repent. And we must choose Jesus as our Savior. There's no other way. Brother Levi, give me an opportunity. See some radical praise in here tonight. I'm hoping I can see somebody say, you know what, today's the day. I'm pushing all this pride aside, and I'm going to choose Jesus as my Savior. And then the altars are going to be full of people praising God. Amen. Let the Spirit fall wherever it may. Now I'm going to offer a prayer tonight, but I'm going to go ahead and tell you. Nobody can do no sin. Pastor Levi can't do any sin. No matter what he can teach you. Amen. Listen, we all need Jesus. If we want to see the blessings from God, we first got to get right with God.
That's right.
So would I have every head bowed, every eye closed, no looking around? Say, dear Heavenly Father, I need you tonight. I need you to forgive me of my sin. Lord, I need a Savior. Lord, I ask you right now if you would move into my heart and become my Savior. Lord, tonight I want to be born again. I believe in everything you did on Calvary's Hill. I believe that you They put you on that cross. You died. And on the third day, after they put you in the grave, God called you from the grave. You ascended into heaven and you're at the right hand of the Father. And you're making intercession for me right now. Father, I need you. I want to be saved. I want to make sure that I know. Something a little different because it's a revival. And I don't want you to do something a little different. I want to move the pride out of your life right now. And I just want you to do this one thing. If you said that prayer and you meant it in your heart, I just want you to stand up right where you are. Just stand up right where you are. God's telling me that there's more than one. Thank you. Thank you, sir. God's telling me that there's more than one in here tonight that needs you. Amen. Amen. Who else would it be? Would it be one more person tonight to say, I need a Savior?
Oh, know that she's standing before us cancer free. The faith that you have in heaven is just incredible.
somebody receive power in this house tonight. Somebody's beginning to be equipped in this house tonight. My God, I feel the power of God. Doesn't somebody feel the power?
Thank you. You can be dismissed in Jesus' name. You are dismissed.